Hello, Intel have finally brought some much needed competition to the graphics card market, especially on the lower, more budget tier, and that's absolutely brilliant, it's much needed. But how do you actually power your Intel GPUs? Whether you've got an Arc one from 2022 or a B580 from the Battlemage range in 2024, do you need to run out and buy a 12 volt power connector from the ATX 3.0 or 3.1 standards? Or can you make do with one of the older style of cables with a 6 pin or 8 pin end? Well, thankfully, you don't need to use the melting 12-volt power connector that NVIDIA cards tend to use and that's had loads of bad press. You don't need one of these. That's because Intel GPUs, whether it's from the Arc range or the Battlemage range, they simply need 6 or 8-pin connectors. So the Arc cards, such as the A580 or the A750, they need two PCI Express connectors. Often they needed a 6-pin connector and then a separate 8-pin connector as well, and I'll talk about that more in a minute. But essentially, if you've got a Corsair PSU like I do, you'll probably have a split end, a 6 and a 2-pin end, so you would just connect those bits together, plug that into your graphics card, and then for the other connector, since it needs two connectors, you would just plug in like that, and then obviously this end would go into your power supply unit, and that would be done. But with Battlemage, they actually got rid of the need to have two separate connections. You just literally need a single 8-pin connection. At least that's true for the B570 and B580 GPUs that got announced towards the end of 2024. If that changes and they release higher end ones, then I'll put a comment down in the description to actually give a bit more information. But right now, at the time of filming, which is the end of 2024, you simply need a single 8-pin connector that you plug into your Intel Battlemage GPU. And then the other end goes into your PSU, and that's it. The only real exception though is ASRock, one of the board partners, they got a 3-fan overclocked variant, and that actually needs two separate 8-pin connectors. But that is the exception to the rule, and that's strictly not required for reasons I'll cover in a minute. And that's why most of the board partners, like the Sparkle one or the original Intel ones, need just one connector. And the reason that that can actually happen, that you only need one PSU cable, is that a cable like this supplies at least 150 watts of power through it, and then the motherboard PCI Express slot you plug your graphics card into supplies another 75 watts of power. So when you add that together, that's at least 225 watts of power that can be supplied from a single cable, a motherboard slot. And obviously Intel's newer GPUs, and actually their Arc ones too, only go up to 225 watts of power supply, so you only ever need one cable, really. Which might make you question why the Arc ones actually needed two cables, even though the TDP was sometimes like 175 watts on the A580. Well, to be honest, there's no good reason for that. It's more historical reasoning, because a cable at this, even if you use the pigtail, would have been enough to supply 175 watts or 225 watts to the Arc GPUs. And I think Intel recognized that, and that's why for the two Battlemage ones that they announced, the B570 and the B580, they got rid of the requirement for having two separate connectors and just said, you need a single cable. And that is how you power your Intel GPU. I hope you found this video useful. If you did, please click the thumbs up button and please subscribe to see more videos like this. Thanks for watching.